So as you can see, my assistant to the shop manager has become mobile, and he's starting to get into everything. So I've decided to build a small cabinet to keep him out of my electronic cords. This cabinet is going to be fitting underneath my window, in between the fireplace and the wall. The dimensions are approximately 49 inches by 12 inches by 20 inches tall. I'm going to start out by cutting the top and the bottom pieces out of a 3/4 inch plywood. On the miter saw, I'm going to cross cut them to the appropriate length. The top is going to have a 1.5 inch hardwood framing around it, so I am going to measure, cut down to allow for that framing. To make the framing, I'm going to set the table saw to 1.5 inches. This will be used to cut all the hardwood. I'm going to be using poplar in this project. Now I'm going to set up a stop block so I can cut the face framing so all the boards are the same length. assemble the face framing, I'm going to be using the most sophisticated and complex joinery method, pocket holes. I will be placing all the pocket holes on the inside of the framing, so it will not, nor will I need to fill the pocket holes after I've inserted the screws. To get updates and notifications, please follow my channel by clicking the subscribe button.
So now that I got my pocket holes drilled, I'm going to now start attaching the framing. The pocket holes are all going to be on the inside, so I have to make sure I line all the holes up on the inside, and that way none of them will be showing. So now I'm going to cut the side hardwood pieces. I need two of them at 8 1/4 and two at 11.25. So I'm going to save some wood and cut each out of one of these boards. Thank you. these are our side panels. And as you can tell, that little groove just adds a little bit of detail. And when it gets stained up, it'll be a little bit darker than everything else to make a nice little shadow line. So now we just got to pocket hole these like we did the other framing. I'm going to use these biscuits. I'm going to put these along the edge here so it'll line up the face fronts of all these with that plywood and add a little bit of strength. And I'll add some glue.
I was originally going to stain these. However, the wife wanted to have them painted white to match the trim and the fireplace. So the changes were made towards the end after it was constructed.
All right, so I've dry fitted all these after I've sanded them down to 320 grit. So what I'm going to do now is make this whole panel one piece.
For the glue up, I'm using a tight bond glue and then a Harbor Freight acid brush to spread the glue into the biscuit joints.
So my next step is to make the top. So the total length of this is going to be 49 inches long.
To cut the top framing, I'm going to cut a 45 degree angle on the first side of the long piece. Then I'm going to place that cut piece along the plywood and mark the inside dimension on the opposite side.
Double check this measurement, but this should be 46. So it's right at 46. So what I want to do is cut the other bevel on the inside edge to 46. Thank you.
I'm then going to cut that side at a 45 degree angle, ensuring the angle is facing the correct way on the miter saw. I then repeat the process for the other long end and then the two short ends. I chose this method because solid wood is more expensive than using a plywood center. I also like the aesthetics of how the plywood is wrapped with the hardwood. The other reason I chose this method is because I do not have a planer, therefore using all solid wood would be hard to have a flush, smooth surface. I was originally going to use biscuits to join all these together, but then I realized that I did not have a clamp that was long enough to do the long edge, so I opted for the sophistication of pocket holes.
So now that I got my top off glued up, I'm going to get all the excess glue off and then raise the granite at the same time. So the next step is I'm going to put pocket holes on the bottom. This will attach to the face frame on the front and to both sides. All right, next thing I need to do is make a bracket for the back along the top for support. The way I'm going to do that is measure it by lining up one end and then drawing the line on the other side. So I'm almost ready to start the glue up. One thing with the design of this door is that this part goes all the way across, whereas this top one does not. So this is going to be my bottom. I wanted the bottom to kind of wrap all the way around, give it a nice clean look, although most of it won't show. That's the style. Typically I would do them both like this from the whole length. So a couple places I'm going to have to do some pocket holes are along the face frame and the sides. So I'm going to put some pocket holes, probably put one right here and then put another one up here on both sides as well as on the bottom as well. Thank you.
So the way I'm going to make the doors is there's going to be a piece of plywood, 1/4 inch, that just floats in the middle here. So I'm going to have to cut a groove along the inside here for this to sit down in and then float around. So what I'm going to do is mark stopping points so I don't go too far on the bottom and top. So this is just an example of what it's going to look like with a groove in there with this temporary cutoff. So it just slides right into this groove and it floats. So next step is to cut the 1/4 inch plywood to fill the gap for the inside of the pane. The next one I'm going to do is pocket hole screw these together for the inside of the door, and then it'll be ready for glue up. As I was routing this, I realized dust was flying in my eyes. I had forgotten my safety glasses. After running the router across everything, I lightly sanded it again, and then I used a Sherwin-Williams paint and painted it with a paintbrush and a roller. That part was not videoed because I accidentally took a photograph opposed to hitting the record button. In the end, the project came out beautifully and it's going to serve its purpose. The assistant to the shop manager can no longer get into my cables and electronics.